Condoleezza Rice was hired, if you will, by the NCAA to form a commission that includes such luminaries as Grant Hill and David Robinson and others to come up with some suggestions on how to fix college basketball in the wake of the scandal that has been made public based on the indictments that the FBI has handed down to several assistant coaches and a member of the shoe industry, et cetera, et cetera. And today she made her announcement.
Okay.
And amongst the ideas that she has posited, she suggested that the NBA remove the one and done from the equation. And she told the NBA and the NBA Players Association, get rid of the one and done. And in order to facilitate that, I guess, she said that if the NBA does not do that, then the NCAA should start considering making freshmen ineligible. And also lock up scholarships as well. And that would, I guess, take some of the problem of one-and-dones off the table and remove a lot of the shenanigans that we're seeing in youth basketball levels and high school basketball levels. Part of also to help that would be to limit but regulate contact with agents in high school in conjunction with the NBA, helping high schoolers understand whether they can go to the pros right away.
Right.
And because the G League or D League or whatever they call it now, the G League can't handle all the kids who don't get drafted into the NBA.
Yes.
Say that even if they've acquired an agent, if you're not drafted, you get to go back, which I like.
I like that too.
Also, get ready for the idea of allowing kids to make money off their own likeness and number. That once that's handled by the court system, that the NCAA should come up with language. So in other words, kick that to the judiciary branch of our government. But at least get ready. Certainly if you're not going to pay the players, okay?
Which they're not.
That's what the idea is. Now, I think the Jay Billis of the world would like to have seen her basically blow it all up and start again. But instead they decided that they were going to strengthen the notion that these kids are still student athletes. Whatever student athlete rules that kind of still apply in the NCAA, they wanted to strengthen this, add more teeth to it rather than tear it all down. And the line that she said that the problems that the NCAA has start in youth basketball, and that's where they've kind of tried to target their issues, to have the kids in youth basketball in these AAU leagues where shoe companies have gotten involved, and have all of these coaches come from all over the place and be part of any sort of youth league or summer league that's going on right now. They've decided to regulate the summer leagues. By 2019, the commission wants to have summer leagues administered only by the NCAA, like officially sanctioned summer leagues, that those are the only ones where college coaches are allowed to attend. So have the NCAA be in charge of the summer leagues, and no shoe companies are allowed in there.
So no more AAU, no more Adidas camp or
summer
Nike
leagues.
Camp.
Summer leagues.
Okay.
Summer leagues.
Well, AAU is mostly.
Well, I mean, they're only administered by the NCAA. So these these big-time college coaches can only show up at these summer leagues. Now, the reason why there's a problem in youth basketball is because you're not paying the players at this level. It all trickles down
right.
Because of the fact that you haven't figured out the main pieces, what to do with these kids. And the problem is, she says, is she doesn't want to professionalize college basketball. Here's a great quote. Most commissioners believe that the rules on name, image, and likeness should be taken up as soon as the legal framework is established. It's hard for the public and, frankly, me to understand what can be allowed with the college model. For instance, I don't understand the difference between Olympic payments, which there's allowed, and participation in Dancing with the Stars and what can't be allowed without opening the door to professionalizing college basketball. She's referring to Arike Ogunbowale, who, you know, made the two great shots to give Notre Dame the championship.
Yes.
She's still eligible but allowed to play allowed to dance with the Stars.
Is she getting paid for Dancing with the Stars?
I'm assuming. I don't know. And she notes that the corruption scheme outlined by federal prosecutors included the use of phony purchase orders to use Adidas money to pay players' families illicitly. And she said, these public companies should be concerned about how their money is being used. I have served on quite a few public boards, and I can tell you this should be an area of concern, which is a way to basically say, don't let the government get involved.
Right.
So to me, I take on all this is that she half measured it. There's a lot of stringent ideas here that do work. She wants to have death penalties for people, coaches who have a who violate the rules, out for life, gone, see ya. Oof. Which is kind of nuts, because who's to decide that? The NCAA, they can't figure anything out.
Exactly.
So that's a what I'm saying is that there's still a sickness that hasn't been completely cured. To me, you know what I took from this? There's a job open in a couple of years that Condoleezza Rice is rumored to be interested in. To basically show, I'm willing to protect a certain business model that the people who have hired me want me to basically protect, and I'm still able to find some problems that the fan base will agree needs to be fixed, and I'm going to show how I can talk to fans, and I can tell some fans that I hear you, but the business model is going to be protected. Who do you think might be interested in that might be willing to hire Condoleezza Rice in a couple of years?
National Football League.
That's what I took out of this.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern on Audience.